In biology, binocular vision is a type of vision in which an animal having two eyes is able to perceive a single three-dimensional image of its surroundings. Neurological researcher Manfred Feil has stated six specific advantages of having two eyes rather than just one. It gives a creature a spare eye in case one is damaged. It gives a wider field of view. For example, humans have a maximum horizontal field of view of approximately 190 degrees with two eyes, approximately 120 degrees of which makes up the binocular field of view, seen by both eyes, flanked by two unioculular fields, seen by only one eye, of approximately 40 degrees. It can give stereopsis in which binocular disparity, or parallax, provided by the two eyes' different positions on the head gives precise depth perception. This also allows a creature to break the camouflage of another creature. It allows the angles of the eyes' lines of sight, relative to each other, vergence, and those lines relative to a particular object, gaze angle, to be determined from the images in the two eyes. These properties are necessary for the third advantage. It allows a creature to see more of, or all of, an object behind an obstacle. This advantage was pointed out by Leonardo da Vinci, who noted that a vertical column closer to the eyes than an object at which a creature is looking might block some of the object from the left eye, but that part of the object might be visible to the right eye. It gives binocular summation in which the ability to detect faint objects is enhanced. Other phenomena of binocular vision include eutrochular discrimination, the ability to tell which of two eyes has been stimulated by light, eye dominance, the habit of using one eye when aiming something, even if both eyes are open, allelotropia, the averaging of the visual direction of objects viewed by each eye when both eyes are open, binocular fusion or singleness of vision, seeing one object with both eyes despite each eye having its own image of the object, and binocular rivalry. Seeing one eye's image alternating randomly with the other when each eye views images that are so different they cannot be fused. Binocular vision helps with performance skills such as catching, grasping, and locomotion. It also allows humans to walk over and around obstacles at greater speed and with more assurance. Optometrists and/or orthoptists are eye care professionals who fix binocular vision problems. Etymology. The term binocular comes from two Latin roots, bini for double, and oculus for eye. Field of view and eye movements. Some animals, usually, but not always, prey animals, have their two eyes positioned on opposite sides of their heads to give the widest possible field of view. Examples include rabbits, buffaloes, and antelopes. In such animals, the eyes often move independently to increase the field of view. Even without moving their eyes, some birds have a 360-degree field of view. Some other animals, usually, but not always, predatory animals, have their two eyes positioned on the front of their heads, thereby allowing for binocular vision and reducing their field of view in favor of stereopsis. However, eyes on the front is a highly evolved trait in vertebrates, and there are only three extant groups of vertebrates with truly forward-facing eyes: primates, carnivorous mammals, and birds of prey. Some predator animals, particularly large ones such as sperm whales and killer whales, have their two eyes positioned on opposite sides of their heads, although it is possible they have some binocular visual field. Other animals that are not necessarily predators, such as fruit bats and a number of primates, also have forward-facing eyes. These are usually animals that need fine depth discrimination/perception. For instance, binocular vision improves the ability to pick a chosen fruit or to find and grasp a particular branch. The direction of a point relative to the head, the angle between the straight ahead position and the apparent position of the point, from the ego center, is called visual direction, or vision. The angle between the line of sight of the two eyes when fixating a point is called the absolute disparity, binocular parallax, or vergence demand, usually just vergence. The relation between the position of the two eyes, vergence, and vergence is described by Herring's law of visual direction. In animals with forward-facing eyes, the eyes usually move together. Eye movements are either conjunctive, in the same direction, vergence eye movements, usually described by their type, saccades or smooth pursuit, also nystagmus and vestibulo-ocular reflex. Or they are disjunctive, in opposite direction, vergence eye movements. The relation between vergence and vergence eye movements in humans, and most animals, is described by Herring's law of equal innervation. Some animals use both of the above strategies. A starling, for example, has laterally placed eyes to cover a wide field of view, but can also move them together to point to the front so their fields overlap, giving stereopsis. A remarkable example is the chameleon, whose eyes appear as if mounted on turrets, each moving independently of the other, up or down, left or right. Nevertheless, the chameleon can bring both of its eyes to bear on a single object when it is hunting, showing vergence and stereopsis. Binocular summation. Binocular summation is the process by which the detection threshold for a stimulus is lower with two eyes than with one. There are various types of possibilities when comparing binocular performance to monocular. Neural binocular summation occurs when the binocular response is greater than the probability summation. Probability summation assumes complete independence between the eyes and predicts a ratio ranging between 9 to 25%. Binocular inhibition occurs when binocular performance is less than monocular performance. This suggests that a weak eye affects a good eye and causes overall combined vision. Maximum binocular summation occurs when monocular sensitivities are equal. Unequal monocular sensitivities decrease binocular summation. There are unequal sensitivities of vision disorders such as unilateral cataract and amblyopia. Other factors that can affect binocular summation include are spatial frequency, stimulated retinal points, and temporal separation. Binocular interaction. Apart from binocular summation, the two eyes can influence each other in at least three ways. Pupillary diameter. Light falling in one eye affects the diameter of the pupils in both eyes. One can easily see this by looking at a friend's eye while he or she closes the other. When the other eye is open, the pupil of the first eye is small. When the other eye is closed, the pupil of the first eye is large. Accommodation and vergence. Accommodation is the state of focus of the eye. If one eye is open and the other closed, and one focuses on something close, the accommodation of the closed eye will become the same as that of the open eye. Moreover, the closed eye will tend to converge to point at the object. Accommodation and convergence are linked by a reflex, so that one evokes the other. Interocular transfer. The state of adaptation of one eye can have a small effect on the state of light adaptation of the other. After effects induced through one eye can be measured through the other. Singleness of vision. Once the fields of view overlap, there is a potential for confusion between the left and right eye's image of the same object. This can be dealt with in two ways. One image can be suppressed, so that only the other is seen, or the two images can be fused. If two images of a single object are seen, this is known as double vision or diplopia. Fusion of images, commonly referred to as binocular fusion, occurs only in a small volume of visual space around where the eyes are fixating. Running through the fixation point in the horizontal plane is a curved line for which objects there fall on corresponding retinal points in the two eyes. This line is called the empirical horizontal horopter. There is also an empirical vertical horopter, which is effectively tilted away from the eyes above the fixation point and towards the eyes below the fixation point. The horizontal and vertical horopters mark the center of the volume of singleness of vision. Within this thin, curved volume, objects nearer and farther than the horopters are seen as single. The volume is known as Penham's fusional area. It's presumably called an area because it was measured by Penham only in the horizontal plane. Outside of Penham's fusional area, volume, double vision occurs. Eye dominance. When each eye has its own image of objects, it becomes impossible to align images outside of Penham's fusional area with an image inside the area. This happens when one has to point to a distant object with one's finger. When one looks at one's fingertip, it is single but there are two images of the distant object. When one looks at the distant object, it is single but there are two images of one's fingertip. To point successfully, one of the double images has to take precedence and one be ignored or suppressed, termed eye dominance. The eye that can both move faster to the object and stay fixated on it is more likely to be termed as the dominant eye. Stereopsis. The overlapping of vision occurs due to the position of the eyes on the head. Eyes are located on the front of the head, not on the sides. This overlap allows each eye to view objects with a slightly different viewpoint. As a result of this overlap of vision, binocular vision provides depth. Stereopsis, from stereo meaning solid or three-dimensional, and opsis meaning appearance or sight, is the impression of depth that is perceived when a scene is viewed with both eyes by someone with normal binocular vision. Binocular viewing of a scene creates two slightly different images of the scene in the two eyes due to the eyes' different positions on the head. These differences, referred to as binocular disparity, provide information that the brain can use to calculate depth in the visual scene, providing a major means of depth perception. There are two aspects of stereopsis: the nature of the stimulus information specifying stereopsis, and the nature of the brain processes responsible for registering that information. The distance between the two eyes on an adult is almost always 6.5 centimeters, and that is the same distance in shift of an image when viewing with only one eye. Retinal disparity is the separation between objects as seen by the left eye and the right eye and helps to provide depth perception. Retinal disparity provides relative depth between two objects, but not exact or absolute depth. The closer objects are to each other, the retinal disparity will be. Neural binocular summation occurs when the binocular response is greater than the probability summation. Probability summation assumes complete independence between the eyes and predicts a ratio ranging between 9 to 25%. Binocular inhibition occurs when binocular performance is less than monocular performance. This suggests that a weak eye affects a good eye and causes overall combined vision. Maximum binocular summation occurs when monocular sensitivities are equal. Unequal monocular sensitivities decrease binocular summation. There are unequal sensitivities of vision disorders such as unilateral cataract and amblyopia. Other factors that can affect binocular summation include are spatial frequency, stimulated retinal points, and temporal separation. Binocular interaction. Apart from binocular summation, the two eyes can influence each other in at least three ways. Pupillary diameter. Light falling in one eye affects the diameter of the pupils in both eyes. One can easily see this by looking at a friend's eye while he or she closes the other. When the other eye is open, the pupil of the first eye is small. When the other eye is closed, the pupil of the first eye is large. Accommodation and vergence. Accommodation is the state of focus of the eye. If one eye is open and the other closed, and one focuses on something close, the accommodation of the closed eye will become the same as that of the open eye. Moreover, the closed eye will tend to converge to point at the object. Accommodation and convergence are linked by a reflex, so that one evokes the other. Interocular transfer. The state of adaptation of one eye can have a small effect on the state of light adaptation of the other. After effects induced through one eye can be measured through the other. Singleness of vision. Once the fields of view overlap, there is a potential for confusion between the left and right eye's image of the same object. This can be dealt with in two ways: one image can be suppressed, so that only the other is seen, or the two images can be fused. If two images of a single object are seen, this is known as double vision or diplopia. Fusion of images, commonly referred to as binocular fusion, occurs only in a small volume of visual space around where the eyes are fixating. Running through the fixation point in the horizontal plane is a curved line for which objects there fall on corresponding retinal points in the two eyes. This line is called the empirical horizontal horopter. There is also an empirical vertical horopter, which is effectively tilted away from the eyes above the fixation point and towards the eyes below the fixation point. The horizontal and vertical horopters mark the center of the volume of singleness of vision. Within this thin, curved volume, objects nearer and farther than the horopters are seen as single. The volume is known as Penham's fusional area. It's presumably called an area because it was measured by Penham only in the horizontal plane. Outside of Penham's fusional area, volume, double vision occurs. Eye dominance. When each eye has its own image of objects, it becomes impossible to align images outside of pinnum's fusional area with an image inside the area. This happens when one has to point to a distant object with one's finger. When one looks at one's fingertip, it is single but there are two images of the distant object. When one looks at the distant object, it is single but there are two images of one's fingertip. To point successfully, one of the double images has to take precedence and one be ignored or suppressed, termed eye dominance. The eye that can both move faster to the object and stay fixated on it is more likely to be termed as the dominant eye. Stereopsis. The overlapping of vision occurs due to the position of the eyes on the head. Eyes are located on the front of the head, not on the sides. This overlap allows each eye to view objects with a slightly different viewpoint. As a result of this overlap of vision, binocular vision provides depth. Stereopsis, from stereo meaning solid or three-dimensional, and opsis meaning appearance or sight, is the impression of depth that is perceived when a scene is viewed with both eyes by someone with normal binocular vision. Binocular viewing of a scene creates two slightly different images of the scene in the two eyes due to the eyes' different positions on the head. These differences, referred to as binocular disparity, provide information that the brain can use to calculate depth in the visual scene, providing a major means of depth perception. There are two aspects of stereopsis: the nature of the stimulus information specifying stereopsis, and the nature of the brain processes responsible for registering that information. The distance between the two eyes on an adult is almost always 6.5 centimeters, and that is the same distance in shift of an image when viewing with only one eye. Retinal disparity is the separation between objects as seen by the left eye and the right eye and helps to provide depth perception. Retinal disparity provides relative depth between two objects, but not exact or absolute depth. The closer objects are to each other, the retinal disparity will be. Neural binocular summation occurs when the binocular response is greater than the probability summation. Probability summation assumes complete independence between the eyes and predicts a ratio ranging between 9 to 25%. Binocular inhibition occurs when binocular performance is less than monocular performance. This suggests that a weak eye affects a good eye and causes overall combined vision. Maximum binocular summation occurs when monocular sensitivities are equal. Unequal monocular sensitivities decrease binocular summation. There are unequal sensitivities of vision disorders such as unilateral cataract and amblyopia. Other factors that can affect binocular summation include are spatial frequency, stimulated retinal points, and temporal separation. Binocular interaction. Apart from binocular summation, the two eyes can influence each other in at least pupillary diameter.